Hello, welcome to all of you in FFB live chemistry class. Organic chemistry में organic compounds जो कि commercially important organic compound हैं, उनकी study हमने शुरू की है. Trihalogen compounds and polyhalogen compounds ये सारी चीजें बात की थी पिछले videos में. आज हमने जो compound लिए हैं वो हैं alcohol group से. तो एल्कोहल के दो मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कार्बोनिल मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एल्कोहल हैं वो है मेथिल एल्कोहल और एथिल एल्कोहल. तो आज हम इन दोनों एल्कोहल के बारे में वन बाय वन डिटेल में स्टडी कराएंगे लोगों को कि मेथिल एल्कोहल एंड एथिल एल्कोहल इनकी प्रॉपर्टीज क्या है, कॉमर्शियली प्रिपेयर्ड किस तरह से किए जाते हैं, इनका जनरल मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन जो है वो तुम लोग जनरल मेथड ऑफ प्रिपरेशन आप एल्कोहल में सारे पढ़ चुके हो. यहाँ हमें लेबोरेटरी प्रिपरेशन एंड कॉमर्शियल प्रिपरेशन मोस्टली डिस्कस करना है. उसके अलावा जो मेन प्रॉपर्टीज है, जनरल प्रॉपर्टी सेम होती है जैसे और मोनोहाइड्रिक एल्कोहल की थी, कुछ स्पेशल प्रॉपर्टीज होती है जिसके बारे में हम आज के क्लास में डिस्कस करेंगे. तो मेन पर्पज है हमारा कि कॉमर्शियली इम्पॉर्टेंट एल्कोहल की कंप्लीट केमिस्ट्री सबको मालूम हो. तो आज जो हमने दो कंपाउंड लिए हैं उस पर पहला कंपाउंड है कॉमर्शियली इम्पॉर्टेंट एल्कोहल में वो है मेथिल एल्कोहल. Now methyl alcohol is known as methanol or carbenol. Molecular formula of methyl alcohol is CH3OH. It is the simplest monohydric alcohol. It is also referred as wood alcohol or wood spirit or wood naphtha, as the earliest method for its preparation was by destructive distillation of wood. It occurs in combined state in some essential oils, oil of wintergreen, that is methyl salicylate, oil of cloves, which is methyl benzoate, oil of orange flowers, which is methyl anthranilate, etc. Now, general method of preparation, methyl alcohol can be obtained by the general method of preparation of monohydric alcohol. Now, here we discuss about the manufacture of methyl alcohol. On a large scale, methyl alcohol is produced by the application of following three methods. First is from wood by its destructive distillation. This is the oldest method for the manufacture of methyl alcohol and is now only of historical importance. It is not used these days as methyl alcohol is mainly manufactured by synthetic method, but in some cases this is also manufactured by this method. In this method, dried wood is heated in a closed iron retort in the absence of air at a temperature of 573 to 773 Kelvin. The volatile products obtained by destructive distillation are condensed. This gives a distillate consisting a thick black tar and aqueous layer. The aqueous layer is known as pyroligneous acid. The diagram of the manufacture of methyl alcohol from wood is इस तरह से. वुड लेते हैं यहाँ कैरेज में, ये दिस इज दी नोन एज डोर जिसपे कि ये मूवेबल व्हीकल से चलने की पोजिशन में होता है. ये है कंडेंसर और आयरन रिटॉर्ट के बीच में ये वुड रखा जाता है. फर्नेस से यहाँ इसको गर्म करते हैं. डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन है ये. उसके बाद कंडेंस से मेथिल एल्कोहल पायरोलिग्नियस एसिड बनता है. कंडेंस से होता हुआ यहाँ वुड गैसेस बाहर निकल जाती हैं और पायरोलिग्नियस एसिड और वुड तार जो कि हैवी होता है वो सेटलिंग टैंक में नीचे होता है, पायरोलिग्नियस एसिड ऊपर लेयर बनाता है. The following products are obtained by destructive distillation of. First is wood gas, as you see in the diagram. First is wood gas. The mixture of gases which cannot be condensed is known as wood gas. It consists of mainly H2, CH2, CO, CO2 and O2. It is used as a fuel. जो ये गैसेस निकलती हैं इनको हम वापस ला करके जो फर्नेस है उसमें एज ए फ्यूल गैस के यूज करते हैं. नाउ पायरोलिग्नियस एसिड, सेकंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट. द एक्वस डिस्टिलेट कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेनली एसिटिक एसिड, 9-10% मेथिल एल्कोहल, 2-3% 9-10% एसिटिक एसिड सबसे ज्यादा होता है इसमें. मेथिल एल्कोहल 2-3% एंड एसीटोन अबाउट 1-2%. द थर्ड पार्ट इज वुड टार. द डार्क कलर्ड हैवी लेयर नोन एज वुड टार कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए मिक्सचर ऑफ क्रिसोस, नेप्थेलीन एंड हायर एल्केन्स. इट इज यूज्ड एज टाइम्बर प्रिजर्वेटिव अंडर द नेम ऑफ क्रियोसोल्ट. Now last part is wood charcoal. It is a solid residue left in the iron retort containing mainly carbon. It is used as domestic fuels. Now recovery of methyl alcohol from pyroligneous acid. It involves the following steps. First, removal of acetic acid. सबसे ज्यादा pyroligneous acid में क्या होता है? Acetic acid. The pyroligneous acid is treated with milk of lime and distilled. Acetic acid reacts with milk of lime, that is calcium hydroxide, to form non-volatile calcium acetate. The reaction is this acetic acid, milk of lime react to form calcium acetate. तो इस तरह से acetic acid अलग होता है हो जाता है. Now the vapors of acetone and a methyl alcohol pass over. Now removal of acetone. The mixture of acetone and methyl alcohol is first dehydrated for quick lime and then fractionally distilled. Crude acetone, which has boiling point 329 Kelvin, and crude methyl alcohol have a boiling point 337.5 are obtained. Now purification of methyl alcohol. The crude methyl alcohol is treated with anhydrous calcium chloride. A solid derivative CaCl2.4CH3OH is formed. This is separated and distilled to get pure methyl alcohol. Now flow sheet of manufacture of methyl alcohol. In short, किस तरह से बनाते हैं वुड का destructive distillation? तो volatile products, non-volatile residue जो charcoal कहलाता है. Volatile products passed into condenser, so it gives uncondensed gases, which is known as wood gas. At distillate allowed to settle, it consists of two part, lower colored layer wood tar and upper layer pyroligneous acid. Pyroligneous acid passed through milk of lime and distill, then residue calcium acetate banta hai, aur distillate mein hota hai methanol and acetone. Now fractionally distilled करने पर acetone मिलता है boiling point 229 Kelvin पे और ये 337 Kelvin में. Acetone purified by sodium bisulfite and methanol purified by anhydrous calcium acetate. इधर calcium acetate को distilled करते हैं H2SO4 के साथ तो acetic acid मिलता है. तो इस तरह से पायरोलिग्नियस एसिड से ये तीनों कंपाउंड अलग किए जाते हैं. ए बेटर मेथड इज टू ट्रीट क्रूड मेथिल एल्कोहल विद ऑक्सैलिक एसिड. सॉलिड मेथिल ऑक्सलेट इज सेपरेटेड एंड बॉइल्ड विद कॉस्टिक पोटाश व्हेन मेथिल एल्कोहल डिस्टिल्स ओवर. It is dried over quick lime and redistilled. Methyl alcohol treated with oxalic acid to form methyl oxalate and it reacts with KOH to form potassium oxalate and methyl alcohol. Now, second method of preparation for manufacture of methyl alcohol from water gas. The carbon monoxide, mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen is known as water gas. Nowadays, methanol is mostly manufactured by this method. Methanol obtained by this method is about 99% pure. The yield is also quantitative. Water gas is formed by passing steam over coke at 1573 Kelvin. Carbon means coke plus H2O, steam hai ye. Temperature and product is water gas. This is a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. ये पूरा डायग्राम है यहाँ पे इस चैम्बर में कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड और हाइड्रोजन होती है बीच में क्या है रेड हॉट कोक लिया गया है उसके बाद ये यहाँ से प्यूरीफायर में जाता है और ऊपर से यहाँ हाइड्रोजन भी एक्सेस हाइड्रोजन भी भेजी जाती है ये दोनों आगे बढ़ते हैं यहाँ सी ओ और एच टू जो यहाँ से आ रही है प्यूरीफाई होकर के सी ओ और एच टू के बीच यहाँ पे कैटलिस्ट है जेड एन ओ प्लस सी आर टू ओ थ्री कैटलिस्ट है यहाँ रिएक्शन होकर के ये मेथिल एल्कोहल बनता है दिस इज द डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ मेथिल एल्कोहल इस तरह से पूरा डायग्राम है नाउ वाटर गैस इज मिक्स्ड विद हाफ इट्स वॉल्यूम ऑफ हाइड्रोजन The mixture is compressed to approximately 200 to 300 atmosphere. It is then passed over a catalyst zinc oxide and chromium trioxide at 573 Kelvin. Methyl alcohol vapors are formed which are condensed. Water gas compressed ki jati hai. This is the temperature 573 and catalyst and after the reaction it forms methyl alcohol. Now third important method is from natural gas. A mixture of methane and oxygen in the 9:1 ratio by volume is passed over copper catalyst at 523 Kelvin. Under pressure 100 atmosphere, methane is oxidized to methanol. The reaction is this oxidation of methyl. Methyl reacts with oxygen. At the presence of Cu and 523 Kelvin temperature, 100 atmospheric pressure, it forms methyl alcohol. Methane requires of this purpose is obtained from natural gas. Now properties of methyl alcohol. तो पहले हम कौन सी property discuss करेंगे? Physical properties. Methyl alcohol is a colorless liquid at boils at 337.5 Kelvin. It is miscible in water in all proportion. It is soluble in organic solvents also. It is itself a good solvent for fats and oils. It is extremely poisonous liquid when taken internally. It causes blindness, insanity and even death. 30 ml of methyl alcohol can cause death on account of this property. It can be used for denaturing ethyl alcohol. That is to make it unfit for drinking purpose. It is inflammable and burned with a faint luminous flame. It has a pleasant smell and burning taste. Methyl alcohol cannot be dehydrated with anhydrous calcium. Chloride as it forms an addition crystalline compound CaCl2.4CH3OH with it. Now chemical properties of methyl alcohol. Chemically it behaves like a typical monohydric alcohol. It shows many of general chemical reactions shown by the monohydric alcohol. Now uses of methyl alcohol. It is used as a solvent of paint, cellulite and varnishes. For the manufacture of formaldehyde and formalin, 40% formaldehyde solution in water. As a fuel, that is petrol substitute, a 20% mixture of methyl alcohol and gasoline as a good motor fuel. It is used as an antifreeze for automobile radiators. Methyl alcohol to denatural ethyl alcohol. The mixture is called methylated spirit. In the preparation of dyes, medicines, and perfumes, methyl salicylate and methyl anthranilate are used in perfumery. Now, analytical test of methyl alcohol. कैसे पहचान करेंगे अगर हमें मेथिल अल्कोहल दिया जाता है तो उसे कहते हैं एनालिटिकल टेस्ट. व्हेन वार्म्ड विद अ लिटिल सैलिसिलिक एसिड इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ फ्यू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ कंसंट्रेटेड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड इट गिव्स अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फ्रेग्रेंट स्मेल ऑफ ऑयल ऑफ विंटर ग्रीन. द कंपाउंड इज मेथिल सैलिसिलेट. द रिएक्शन लाइक दिस. Methyl alcohol reacts with salicylic acid in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid to form methyl salicylate. Second test, with ceric ammonium nitrate, it gives a red color. Unlike ethyl alcohol, it does not give iodoform test. When a red hot copper wire is dipped in methyl alcohol contained in a test tube, a characteristic pungent smell of formaldehyde is observed. A pungent smell of formaldehyde is also observed when methyl alcohol is warmed with potassium dichromate and dilute sulfuric acid. तो इस तरह से ये methyl alcohol की complete study हुई. इसके बाद अगला कंपाउंड एल्कोहल फैमिली से है एथिल एल्कोहल. तो ये एल्कोहल्स ऑफ कॉमर्शियली इम्पोर्टेंस इस पे हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं. तो अब सेकेंड एल्कोहल विच इज कॉमर्शियली इम्पोर्टेंट इज एथिल एल्कोहल. एथिल एल्कोहल और एथेनॉल और मेथिल कार्बिनॉल. मॉलिकुलर फार्मूला C2H5OH. सेकेंड मेंबर ऑफ द एल्कोहल फैमिली. नाउ एथिल एल्कोहल इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट मेंबर ऑफ द एल्कोहल सीरीज एंड इज कॉमनली नोन एज एल्कोहल. इट इज एन इसेंशियल कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ ऑल वाइन्स. इट इज कॉल्ड स्पिरिट ऑफ वाइन. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ग्रेन एल्कोहल because it is obtained from starchy grain. In combined form, it exists as ester in essential oils. तो जनरल में किसी भी जनरल मेथड से इसको प्रिपेयर किया जा सकता है. यहाँ हम डिस्कस करेंगे मैन्युफैक्चर और इंडस्ट्रियल प्रिपरेशन. ऑन लार्ज स्केल एथिल एल्कोहल इज मैन्युफैक्चर्ड बाई आइदर केमिकल सिंथेसिस और फर्मेंटेशन प्रोसेस. पहले देखते हैं केमिकल सिंथेसिस. दिस इज द मॉडर्न मेथड जो आजकल यूज होता है. देर आर टू रॉ मटेरियल्स एथिलीन एंड एसिटिलीन विच आर यूज फॉर केमिकल सिंथेसिस ऑफ एथिल एल्कोहल. फर्स्ट फ्रॉम एथिलीन large quantity of ethylene are available from petroleum refineries. This is formed during cracking of petroleum. Ethylene is passed into concentrated sulfuric acid at 348. This is 348 to 353 Kelvin under pressure when mixture of ethyl alcohol, ethyl hydrogen sulfate and diethyl sulfate is formed. Reaction is here. Ethylene reacts with sulfuric acid at the temperature 348 to 353 Kelvin under pressure. It forms ethyl hydrogen sulfate, which converted into diethyl sulfate, then react with ethylene again. The reaction mixture is distilled with water and warm when hydrolysis occurs and ethyl alcohol is obtained together with some other as a byproduct. The ethyl hydrogen sulfate or diethyl sulfate जो बना इसकी hydrolysis कराते हैं, गर्म करते हैं, तो ethyl alcohol बनता है और साथ में sulfuric acid बनता है. The yield of ethyl alcohol by this method is 90%. The aqueous solution is distilled to separate ethyl alcohol from sulfuric acid. Now, second alternate method is here. Ethylene may be converted to ethyl alcohol by direct hydration. Ethylene and steam are preheated to 573 Kelvin and then passed under high pressure into reactor, that is stainless steel vessels containing phosphoric acid as catalyst. The reaction products are cooled and passed into the scrubber where ethyl alcohol is dissolved in water. The aqueous solution of ethyl alcohol is then distilled to 95% pure alcohol, that is 5% water present. The yield of ethyl alcohol is 95%. Reaction like this, ethylene reacts with water in presence of phosphoric acid at 573 Kelvin and 70 atmospheric pressure. It forms ethyl alcohol. Now another method, synthetic method, is from acetylene. Acetylene is first converted into acetaldehyde, which on reduction yields ethyl alcohol. Acetylene is passed through 40% of sulfuric acid containing approximately 1% mercuric sulfate at 333 Kelvin. Acetylene is converted into acetaldehyde. The reaction is like this. Acetylene reacts with water in presence of sulfuric acid, 40% sulfuric acid and 1% mercuric sulfate at the temperature 333 Kelvin. It forms vinyl alcohol, which is unstable and forms acetaldehyde. The vapors of acetaldehyde are mixed with hydrogen and passed over finely divided nickel at 383 to 413 Kelvin when ethyl alcohol is formed by reduction of acetaldehyde. Reaction is that reduction of acetaldehyde in presence of nickel at this temperature to form ethyl alcohol. Now, second method, pyrethroid synthetic method, preparation for methyl alcohol. Aur ab hum aate hain fermentation process pe. Second method. This is one of the earliest and most important method for preparing various types of alcoholic preparation. In alcoholic fermentation, cane sugar or glucose are the fermenting materials. There are many products which contains these sugars or can be easily converted into them, is a potential source of ethyl alcohol. The raw material for the manufacture of alcohol are substance containing fermentable sugars such as cane sugar, beets, dates, molasses and fruit juices. These are the raw materials for the manufacture of alcohol. Second, substance containing starch, which such as potatoes, rice, barley, and maize. Molasses is the cheapest source of sucrose, and it forms an excellent raw material for making ethyl alcohol. Prior to World War II, the fermentation of molasses accounted for about 75% of total world production of ethyl alcohol, but today hardly 10% ethyl alcohol is produced by this method. 90% alcohol is produced from ethylene and acetylene. In India, molasses is still the main source of ethyl alcohol. The detail of manufacture are given here. Now, manufacture of ethyl alcohol by fermentation method. This is known as alcoholic fermentation. This is the oldest method for the industrial preparation of ethyl alcohol. The conversion of sugar into ethyl alcohol by yeast is called alcoholic fermentation. In alcoholic fermentation, cane sugar or glucose are fermenting materials. Therefore, many natural products which contains these sugars or can be easily converted into them becomes a source of ethyl alcohol. The raw materials for alcohol industry are materials containing sugars like cane sugar, beets, dates, molasses, and fruit juice. The cheapest source is molasses. Materials containing starch like potato, rice, barley, and maize. Now manufactured from molasses. Molasses is a dark colored syrupy mass left after the separation of cane sugar or beet sugar crystal from the concentrated juice. It still contains 30% of uncrystallized sucrose and about 32% of invert sugar. A mixture of glucose and fructose, it forms an excellent cheap source of industrial ethyl alcohol. The various steps involved in the manufacture of ethyl alcohol. First is dilution. The molasses is distilled with water until a concentration of 8 to 10% is sugar. 8 to 10% sugar is obtained in solution. A small amount of dilute sulfuric acid is added. A small amount of dilute sulfuric acid is added as to adjust the pH value of solution about 4 to 4.5%. The acidity is favored for the growth of yeast but unfavorable for the growth of undesirable bacteria. To this solution, a small quantity of ammonium sulfate is added, which acts as a food for the yeast cell. Second step is alcoholic fermentation. The dilute solution is taken in big fermentation tanks and some yeast is added, 5% by volume of the liquid. The mixture is allowed to stand for a few days. The temperature is kept about 303 Kelvin. Fermentation sets in and the enzyme invertase converts sucrose into glucose. And fructose, which are the invertase converts sucrose into glucose and fructose, which are further converted into ethyl alcohol by another enzyme, gymase. The reaction like this: cane sugar, which is contains sucrose, hydrolysis takes place in presence of invertase enzyme, and it converted into glucose and fructose. Then glucose or fructose converted into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide by gymase enzyme. The fermentation is complete in 3 days and carbon dioxide is recovered as a byproduct. The fermentation liquid is filtered. This is the diagram for the preparation of methyl alcohol. Is tarah se यहाँ से स्टीम भेजी जाती है. दिस इज द एनालाइजर और यहाँ पे वॉल पाइप और ये स्टीम एंड एल्कोहल वेपर्स यहाँ से पास होती हैं. इस चैम्बर में रेक्टिफायर में जाती हैं, जहाँ से फिर ये एल्कोहल वेपर्स कंडेंसर में जाती है और यहाँ एल्कोहल 90% मिलता है. दिस इज द मैनुफैक्चर डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन फॉर द मैनुफैक्चर ऑफ एथिल एल्कोहल बाय फर्मेंटेशन. तो ये डायग्राम है पूरा, जहाँ पे फर्मेंटेशन स्टीम के साथ जो मोलेशेस होते हैं उसको रख करके कराया जाता है. नाउ थर्ड प्रोसेस इज फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. The fermented liquor is technically called as wash or wort. The fermented liquor is technically called as a wash or wort, जो नीचे डायग्राम में दिखा था. The approximate composition of wash is 6 to 10% ethyl alcohol and 3 to 5% glycerol. और ये wash कहाँ पे है? डायग्राम में ये देख सकते हो, spent wash, इसमें ये composition है. 6 to 10% है एथिल एल्कोहल एंड 3 to 5% ग्लिसरॉल. and higher alcohols, that is fused oil and acetaldehyde, etc. Wash is subjected to fractional distillation in a coffee still. Each coffee still consists of two fractionating columns known as analyzer and rectifier, which are provided with perforated plates. जिसको डायग्राम में था, it works on counter current principle. The wash is prepared by circulating it through the coil round the rectifier and then introduced into the analyzer. A current of steam is passed from the bottom of the analyzer. Variably, the alcohol and other volatile constituents present in the wash rise up along with the steam and enter the rectifier. In upward passage, steam goes on condensing while the vapors of alcohol leaving from the top of the rectifier are condensed and collected. This is known as raw spirit and contains about 90% alcohol. The liquid collected at the bottom of analyzer is called spent wash. Now, rectification. Ethyl alcohol obtained above contains, in addition to wash, various. Ethyl alcohol obtained above contains, in addition to water, various other impurities. Ethyl alcohol obtained above contains, in addition to water, various other impurities, which are removed by careful fractional distillation. The following fractions are obtained. First fraction, it contains low boiling liquids like acetaldehyde. Second fraction is contained 93.95% ethyl alcohol and is called rectified spirit. Last fraction contains water and fused oil. Fused oil is a mixture of N-propyl, N-butyl, N-amyl, isoamyl and optically active amyl alcohol. Now from starch, ये था molasses से किस तरह से, जो कि cane sugar की, तो जब cane sugar से जब बनाया जाता है sugar, तो उस position में जो molasses मिलता है उससे fermentation बताया था. अब दूसरा method है fermentation में, वो फ्रॉम स्टार्च से किस तरह से बनते हैं. फर्स्ट मेथड, इन फर्स्ट मेथड ग्लूकोज इज और स्टार्च इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू ग्लूकोज और सुक्रोज. सुक्रोज इज फर्स्ट कन्वर्टेड इनटू फ्रक्टोज एंड ग्लूकोज एंड देन कन्वर्टेड इनटू एथिल अल्कोहल. अब यहाँ सेकंड मेथड है फर्मेंटेशन में, फ्रॉम स्टार्च मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ मेथिल अल्कोहल by the fermentation method with the help of starch. The manufacture of ethyl alcohol from starchy materials like potatoes, barley, maize, etc. involves the following steps. First is saccharification. The starch is first converted into maltose. The process of conversion is known as saccharification. It completes in three steps. First, malting. Moist barley is allowed to germinate in dark at 288 Kelvin. Germinated barley card malt is heated to 333 Kelvin to stop the further growth. This is the malting. It is crushed, extracted with water and filtered. The filtrate containing diastase enzyme is known as malt extract. Now, second step is mashing. The process of liberating starch from starchy material is called mashing. The starchy material is treated with superheated steam as to break the cell walls and to form a paste-like mass called mash. Third step is hydrolysis. Malt extract is added to mash. First or second method mein jo mila, malt extract and mash is added at 323 to 333 Kelvin. The enzyme diastase hydrolyzes the starch into maltose in about half an hour's time. the reaction is this. This is the starch. Hydrolysis takes place presence of diester at 323 to 333 Kelvin. It forms maltose. Now, second step is alcoholic fermentation. The hydrolyzed starch solution containing maltose is then fermented by yeast for 2 to 3 days at 300 Kelvin. The enzyme maltase present in the yeast hydrolyzed maltose into glucose. The other enzyme, gynase, present in the yeast convert glucose into ethyl alcohol. The maltose hydrolysis takes place in presence of maltase enzyme. It converted into glucose, and this glucose is converted into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide by enzyme gynase. Now, third step is distillation and rectification of the fermented liquid. This is done in similar ways as described in the first method as the same. Now, preparation of absolute alcohol. A rectified spirit contains 95.5% ethyl alcohol and 4.5% water. It is a constant boiling mixture. This is azeotropic solution, and water cannot be removed simply by distillation. Hence, some special methods are adopted for removing water from rectified spirit as to obtain 100% ethyl alcohol, which is known as absolute alcohol. In the laboratory, absolute alcohol is prepared by keeping rectified spirit in contact with calculated amount of quicklime, that is calcium oxide, for a few hours and then refluxing and distilling it. Commercially, absolute alcohol can be obtained by adding a suitable amount of benzene to the rectified spirit and then fractional distilling. The first fraction obtained at 337.8 Kelvin is an azeotropic mixture of water. So in this mixture, 7.4% water, alcohol 18.5% and benzene 74.1%. This removes water completely. The second fraction obtained at 341.52 Kelvin is an azeotropic mixture of benzene and ethanol. In this picture, benzene 67.6% and ethanol 32.4. This removes benzene completely. Finally, absolute alcohol distilled over at 351.3 Kelvin as the last fraction. Uske baad aa jao, what is methylated spirit or what is denatured alcohol? Methylated spirit or denatured alcohol. In order to make the industrial alcohol unfit for drinking purposes, the rectified alcohol is denatured by adding various poisonous compounds. In most of the countries, the denaturing is done by adding 5 to 10% of methyl alcohol and 0.5% of pyridine or petroleum naphtha. In India, it is usually denatured by adding 0.5% rubber distillate, that is, and 0.5% pyridine bases. This denatured spirit is 95% ethyl alcohol and 5% methyl alcohol. The methylated spirit is a mixture of 90% ethyl alcohol, 9% methyl alcohol and 1% other poisonous substance like pyridine or petroleum oil, etc. And power alcohol. It has been found that absolute ethyl alcohol mixed with petrol and benzene can be used As a motor fuel, alcohol thus need for generating power is called power alcohol. A mixture of 20% absolute alcohol and 80% petrol gasoline is used in an internal combustion engine to drive power. Since alcohol itself does not mix with petrol, therefore a third solvent such as benzene, ether or tetraline is used as solvent. Now, properties of ethyl alcohol. First, physical properties. Ethyl alcohol is a colorless liquid with a characteristic pleasant smell that is known as alcoholic smell and burning taste. It is inflammable and burns with a blue flame. It boils at 351 Kelvin and has specific gravity 0.789 at 293 Kelvin. Unlike methyl alcohol, it is not a toxic liquid. It mixes with water in all proportion. It dissolves in water with evolution of heat and contraction in volume. It forms a constant boiling mixture which contains 95.6% ethyl alcohol and 4.4% of water with water. It is also miscible with a number of organic solvents. Ethyl alcohol is a good solvent for oil, fat, resins, etc. It also dissolves inorganic substances like caustic soda, sulfur, phosphorus, etc. Like methyl alcohol, it cannot be dried over anhydrous calcium chloride as it forms an addition product, CaCl2.4C2H5OH. When taken internally, ethyl alcohol is readily oxidized by the system and is therefore an important source of immediate energy. The blood begins to flow faster and dilates the blood vessels. Now, chemical properties of the ethyl alcohol in a short form, in a chart. This is the summary chart of chemical reaction of ethyl alcohol. तो ये ethyl alcohol से जब reaction होते हैं तो क्या क्या बन रहे हैं अभी ये बताया कि anhydrous calcium carbide calcium chloride के साथ ये addition product बनाता है. At burning ethyl alcohol gives carbon dioxide and water. Ethyl alcohol reacts with sodium to form sodium ethoxide. It reacts with acetic acid in presence of sulfuric concentrated sulfuric acid. It forms ethyl acetate. Now it heated with methanol chloride to form ethyl acetate. Ethyl alcohol reacts with pyridine to form ethyl acetate, and it reacts. रिएक्शन चल रहा था इतने रिएक्शन बता दिए थे. नाउ इट रिएक्ट्स एथिल अल्कोहल रिएक्ट्स विद ग्रिग्नार रीजन टू फॉर्म मीथेन एंड दिस रिएक्ट्स विद PCl3 और PCl5 टू फॉर्म एथिल क्लोराइड. एथिल अल्कोहल रिएक्ट्स विद फास्फोरस पेंटाब्रोम ट्राइब्रोमाइड इन प्रेजेंस और विद रेड फास्फोरस एंड ब्रोमीन इट फॉर्म्स एथिल ब्रोमाइड. इट रिएक्ट्स विद फास्फोरस tribromide in or red phosphorus and iodine to form ethyl iodide, and it reacts with sulfonyl chloride in presence of pyridine, it forms ethyl chloride. इसी तरह से HCl और zinc chloride के साथ reduction होता है तो ये reaction होता है तो ethyl chloride बनता है. कंसंट्रेट HBr या कंसंट्रेट सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड के साथ एथिल ब्रोमाइड, कंसंट्रेट HI के साथ एथिल ब्रोमाइड बनाता है, कंसंट्रेट HNO3 के साथ एथिल नाइट्रेट, कंसंट्रेट सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड के साथ एथिल हाइड्रोजन सल्फेट. ये एथिल हाइड्रोजन सल्फेट एक्सेस ऑफ अल्कोहल से रिएक्शन करता है एट दिस टेम्परेचर टू फॉर्म्स डाई एथिल एथर. And at the temperature 433.443 in presence of concentrated H2SO4 it forms ethylene. तो ये बहुत ही important reaction है. Ethyl alcohol reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid at this temperature to form ethyl hydrogen sulfate. And this reacts again with ethyl alcohol at 413 Kelvin it forms diethyl ether. अगर ये टेम्परेचर हम बढ़ाते हैं और कंसंट्रेट सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड लेते हैं इस टेम्परेचर पे तो एथिलीन बनता है. नाउ इट रिएक्ट्स विद एल्यूमिना एट 623 इट फॉर्म्स एथिलीन एंड एथिलीन एंड इट रिएक्ट्स विद एल्यूमिना एट 523 इट फॉर्म्स डाइएथिल ईथर. नाउ एथिल अल्कोहल रिएक्ट्स विद हाइड्रोजन आयोडाइड एंड रेड फॉस्फोरस टू फॉर्म्स एथेन. उसके अलावा डाइल्यूट सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड की प्रेजेंस में पोटेशियम डाइक्रोमेट या सोडियम डाइक्रोमेट से रिएक्शन करके ये एसिड एल्डिहाइड पे बदल जाता है जिसका ऑक्सीडेशन होने पे एसिटिक एसिड बनता है. इट रिएक्ट्स विद कॉपर एट 573 इट फॉर्म्स एसिड एल्डिहाइड. एथिल अल्कोहल रिएक्ट्स विद क्लोरीन टू फॉर्म फर्स्ट एसिड एल्डिहाइड एंड अगेन रिएक्ट्स विद क्लोरीन टू फॉर्म क्लोरल. And ethyl alcohol reacts with bleaching powder, it forms chloroform. It also reacts with iodine and NaOH to form iodoform. This is iodoform reaction. And it reacts with bromine and NaOH. दोनों ही सभी reaction में से heat करते हैं. It forms bromoform. Now it reacts with chlorine and NaOH. It forms chloroform. And ethyl alcohol reacts with acid aldehyde with DiHCl is form hemiacetal. This is the compound which on reaction with ethyl alcohol again it forms acetal. Now uses of ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is one of the most extensively used organic compounds. Its main use are it is in the manufacture of alcoholic beverage as a solvent for para acetyl preparation and in a constituent of medicines, as a solvent of for paint, tile, perfumes, dyes, varnishes, gums, etc. It is used as a preservative for biological specimens. It is used in the manufacture of acetaldehyde, acetic acid, ethyl halides, ethyl acetate, chloroform, iodoform, etc. Ethyl alcohol is used as an antifreeze in automobile radiators, and it is used as a raw for freezing and mobile liquid in scientific apparatus such as thermometer and spirit levels. It is used in hospital as an antiseptic. It is used as a fuel in spirit lamp and stove. It is used as a petrol substitute, that is power alcohol. Now laboratory reagent. It is used as a laboratory reagent, as a reaction medium, extraction and crystallizing agent. Ethyl alcohol used for making solid alcohol fuel. It is prepared by mixing ethyl alcohol with saturated calcium acetate solution. A solid gel is formed which is known as canned heat or a solid alcohol. It burns like alcohol. In the manufacture of vinegar, dilute acetic acid. In the manufacture of vinegar, which is known as chemical name of vinegar is dilute acetic acid. From ethyl alcohol by the activity of mycoderma acetic. ethyl alcohol reacts with the oxygen of air in presence of mycoderma acetate. This is the bacteria. It forms acetic acid. Now, analytical test of ethyl alcohol. The most important of test of this is iodoform test. When a few drops of alcohol are warmed with dilute and potassium dilute iodine. When a few drops of alcohol are warmed with iodine and potassium hydroxide, yellow precipitate of iodoform with characteristic smell is obtained. रिएक्शन देख चुके हो पहले ही. ईस्टर टेस्ट होता है सेकंड. बढ़ाने पे देखते हैं. व्हेन अल्कोहल इज हीटेड जेंटली विद सोडियम एसीटेट एंड कंसंट्रेटेड सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड ए कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फ्रूटी ऑर्डर ऑफ मेथिल एसीटेट इज फॉर्म. एसिडिफाइड पोटेशियम डाइक्रोमेट टेस्ट. थर्ड टेस्ट analytical test of ethyl alcohol is ethyl alcohol when heated with potassium dichromate and dilute sulfuric acid is oxidized to acetaldehyde which has a characteristic pungent smell. If a paper dipped in ammonical silver nitrate solution is dipped in this solution, a black spot appear on the paper due to reduction of silver nitrate by acetaldehyde. Now another test is ceric ammonium nitrate test. With a few drops of alcohol and dilute ceric ammonium nitrate, a red color indicate alcoholic hydroxy group. Now fermentation and enzyme action. In our daily life, we come across certain chemical changes such as rottening of fruits or vegetables, soaring of kneaded flour, putrefaction of meat or food, conversion of fruit juice and sugars into wines, soaring of milk or curd, etc., in which decomposition of complex organic compounds into simpler substance take place in presence of living microorganism. These changes are termed as fermentation process. The word fermentation has been derived from the Latin word ferver, meaning to boil. As during fermentation, there is lot of frothing due to evolution of carbon dioxide and it gives the appearance of boiling liquid. Thus, द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्मेंटेशन. तो फर्मेंटेशन प्रोसेस से मेथिल एल्कोहल बनाना तो पढ़ लिया, अब ये फर्मेंटेशन है क्या इसके बारे में बताया गया है. द प्रोसेस ऑफ फर्मेंटेशन इज द स्लो डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स इनटू सिंपलर सब्सटेंसेस थ्रू द एजेंसी ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नाइट्रोजीनियस कंपाउंड्स कॉल्ड एंजाइम प्रोड्यूस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. Fermentation processes are generally accompanied by the evolution of gases like carbon dioxide, methane, and are exothermic in nature. This is the fermentation. क्या होता है इसके बारे में यहाँ पे बताया शॉर्ट में. तो जिससे अब पहले जो fermentation process पढ़ा वो clear हो गया कि आपके fermentation reaction में actually जो हमें appear होता दिखाई देता है वो क्या है. तो उसमें हमें एक बॉयलिंग मिक्सचर की तरह सीन होता है क्योंकि कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड गैस निकलती है जिसको इन जनरल हम कहते हैं बुदाहट के साथ गैस निकलना. तो ये प्रोसेस फर्मेंटेशन का होता है. तो इस तरह से हमने मेथिल एल्कोहल और एथिल एल्कोहल के बारे में डिटेल में तुम लोगों से डिस्कस किया. उम्मीद है पूरी जानकारी इन दोनों के बारे में मिली होगी और आगे भी हम और दूसरे कंपाउंड्स के बारे में डिस्कस करते रहेंगे.